drug, however, was an unlikely heroine. Her story now from John Tesh.
Kenny, listen to me. You can do it. Yes. 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 Right. Kenny, don't slow down. Don't slow down. Yes.
Focus, Carrie. Just gotta focus, baby.
Years ago, Carrie Strug was 14 years old, the youngest member on the U.S. team. She accomplished what most kids her age can only dream about, a bronze medal in the Olympics. Her training partner, Kim Zmesko, who was favored to win, fell off the beam in the first few moments of the games. And when Kim's dream vanished, the only one there for comfort was Carrie. And when the light was gone in Kim's career, Bella Karoly announced he was quitting. And so it was that Carrie found herself alone.
We thought after the Olympics she would come home. She would come home and live with us and go to school and, quote, be a normal teenage girl.
Carrie decided the solution was to train with the very best. So she went to Shannon Miller's gym with Shannon Miller's coach, in Shannon Miller's hometown, and in Shannon Miller's shadow. Carrie Shepherd was off on his own search. His defeat in Barcelona rang loudly in his ears, and he needed to hear something else. Carrie had found herself a new gym, and with it, a loneliness that she had never known. When the sun beat down on Shannon Miller, it was Strug who always wore her shadow. Where was the only man who could make her dream come true? Why, when Bella spoke of the next Nadia, did he never speak of her? Carrie found herself living in someone else's dream, but when she was interviewed, everything was nice.
We push each other, and you know, one day Shannon's on top, and hopefully another day I will be. So it's a good way of training because it pushes you to do harder, and it's nice to have someone in the gym that can do that with you.
Strug had pushed herself into a serious injury, overtrained and burned out. It was her mom and dad who were desperate to reclaim their baby girl.
As parents, we're now interceding. And if that was one time, I think, when we said, enough's enough.
You need to come home.
We need to regroup.
The crowds, the tension, the urgency. One long, deep breath, and they were suddenly gone, baked away in the heat of the desert. Carrie retreated to the safety of her parents' home in Tucson. And for once, it was gymnastics on her own terms. With the help of USA Gymnastics, she found a new coach in former Soviet Arthur Akopian. The decisions were made together. And with expatriate Romanian Geza Pozar, who had defected with Bella, it was now the Strug's grand experiment. She had returned home to finish high school. She had her parents for support. And this time, Carrie was casting her own shadow. And on this day, at a tiny meet in Palm Springs, it was the acid test, August 3rd, 1994.
Hold it still.
it was one of these terrifying moments. And, you know, I mean, I was there on the floor in my head, if not physically. And I think Melanie was the same way. When you have a child that you see gets injured, I mean, you wish it was you and not your child.
It was an injury so bad they thought she might never walk again. Yet Carrie was determined, convinced she would dance again.
I'm obviously upset that I'm not able to compete in the nationals. And, you know, this is the first time in 4 years that I haven't been there. So it's hard. You know, I'm going to watch it on TV. And it's hard to see the other girls and you say, you know, I work so hard and, you know, I wish I could be there and show everyone that I've come back and I'm still, you know, up there and doing well. But I'll have my chance.
Her chance came in Dortmund, Germany. Carrie's resolve to rehabilitate her body and her career would be tested at the World Championships.
Ever since the fall, I have been terrified. I go to the meets and I am sick. I mean, literally, my stomach, my head, I get just, I'm so filled with fear of her getting hurt.
And so 3 months after she left the gym in an ambulance, Carrie Strug again faced the uneven parallel bars. Shannon Miller had pulled out of the competition in Dortmund, and so it was up to Strug to lead the Americans. And in a meet on the world stage that stunned the superpowers of gymnastics, Strug and her teammates won the silver medal. And while Carrie made her courageous return to competition, the piece of her life she was missing had also returned with someone else. Bella was back in Houston, and this time it was a little girl named Dominique. And it was the coach who was heard to say, "When I look at her, I see Nadia." Strug moved to yet another coach, her fourth change in 3 years. She moved to Tom Forrester's gym just 1 month before the 95 Nationals, and it was supposed to be the gym where she would be the star. She left unhappy.
Well, one thing we knew when we, you know, when Carrie came is that she certainly displayed the ability to leave.
Caroli had not only come back from retirement, he had now built a national champion at 13 years young. And the man who had made Nadia and Mary Lou was ready to introduce the world to Dominique.
You won it, Bobby. You won it. Congratulations. Good job.
Carrie's opportunity to train again with Bella was beyond tempting, but she would have to crawl back into the shadows.
Coming back to Crowley's, I was a little bit nervous and excited at the same time. And Bella, he's changed a little bit. He's more easily to talk. I can talk to him more easily now, and you know, he realized, we talked to them before I came back, saying that I'm 18, I'm not 14 anymore, and you know, my physical capabilities are a little bit different. I can't, you know, do quite as many repetitions. So that's the only thing that's changed. The coaching technique is still the same, and all their methods are still the same as 92, and that's why I wanted to come back.
Hop. Good.
Good.
Carrie was like a running engine, but not a smooth running engine. A hard, strong, aggressively running engine. I've seen her like I never seen before. The fire I seen on her eye, the desire and the hunger. I'm gonna make it. I want to make it. I want to make it. And she showed by the performance every day in the gym.
Fire, desire, and hunger. The ingredients that lifted a Carrie no one had ever seen before through a competition known as the American Cup. Strug had her coach and her confidence back, and she reigned over everyone in the meet.
Her head was up, her eye was bright, her chest was out, and you could see, I'm Carrie, the one who is a winner.
Atlanta Centennial Olympic Games, Carrie's first vault.
To all of us that we needed five good scores to secure the gold medal. Vaulting moves faster than the floor exercise, and the last two girls for Russia were still had to go, and they were totally capable of scoring very high. And so I knew we needed, you know, a good high score to secure the medal.
And she felt the burden, being that sensitive little girl who always worries about what everyone else thinks about her.
She didn't want to let anyone down.
That she wasn't going to be remembered for falling on her rear end. She was going to be remembered for doing the best vault that she could possibly do to get the medal for the team.
Great feeling knowing that I gave it my all and everyone knew it and everyone really appreciated it. I think it made it just so special. You know, it was just so special as my dream had come true. A little bit different than I had planned, but it still came true.
It was a golden kiss from athlete to coach, coach to athlete. And for Carrie Strug, no sign of shadows anywhere.
Carrie Strug had qualified for tonight's event finals in the vault. Earlier, she tested the sprained left ankle, but never got as far as attempting a vault, and she's out.